Hi guys, it's April. Hope you're having a great week. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for the latest videos and updates. I'm a yoga instructor here in Minneapolis, and today I wanted to share with you some tips and tricks if you're new to yoga, or if you already have an experienced yoga practice. So the first thing I wanted to share with you are the items that you need to bring to a class. The first thing you'll need is a yoga mat. And there's plenty of different kinds of yoga mats. You can certainly get a yoga mat from Target. I'm sure Dick's Sporting Goods and things like that have them. You can also buy yoga mats from the studio, which oftentimes are a little more expensive, but provide a little more cushion as you are practicing different postures. The next thing that's helpful to have is a water bottle, because you'll get thirsty during your practice. I use this one from the brand BKR. It might look familiar from my travel favorites video. It's a glass water bottle encased in silicone. And the reason I like this is it has a small drinking spout so that when I drink in the middle of class, I don't get water all over me. The other thing that's helpful to have handy is a small towel. So especially if you're going to a heated class, you might want something like this to wipe your sweat as you're flowing through your practice. Finally, the last thing I'd recommend bringing with you is a larger towel to lay on your mat, perhaps when your mat gets sweaty. So I love these yogi toes. And what a yogi toe is, it's a towel the length of your mat. One side has silicone kind of dots, so it sticks to your mat and doesn't move. And the other side, as you sweat, becomes a lot less slippery, so you're not slipping all over your mat when you're trying to hold a posture. So those are the things I would recommend. Again, you can usually rent them from a yoga studio where you're practicing for a very small fee if you don't have your own and you're just getting into your practice. So what else do you need besides the things to go to a practice with? So I recommend you come to practice with an open mind. Whether it's your new practice or you're deep into your practice, your body likely feels different every day, and you need to be patient and gentle with yourself. The other thing that's important to keep in mind is to bring a sense of non-judgment to your practice. You might be practicing with some folks who have been practicing yoga for years and years and years, and their practice is very advanced and experienced. And you might be practicing with some people that it's their very first time. So practice non-judgment of yourself and non-judgment of others as you move through class. Knowing that there might be some experienced people in class, definitely look to others for guidance if you're not familiar with the names of the postures or how your body should look. But always, always keep in mind how your body feels first and foremost. So honor sensation in your body. You're not gonna always look like your neighbor, and you likely shouldn't look like your neighbor as you're practicing yoga. The last thing I'd keep in mind as you go to yoga class, typically class starts in a posture called child's pose. And you're welcome to take child's pose at any time throughout the practice if you need a rest, or if your breath becomes kind of overwhelming or you get dizzy or whatnot, especially in a heated class. So definitely take child's pose as often as you need. The other thing I wanna touch on for yoga practice, a lot of people think of yoga as the postures or the asanas and how you move your body from one posture to the other. The foundation of the yoga practice is actually your breath. So it's most important to keep a calm and steady breath as you move through challenging postures. This is also helpful when you move off of your yoga mat and into real life, that you use your breath in order to be calm and steady as you face challenges throughout the day. So what are the benefits to practicing yoga versus any other form of exercise? Well, not only does yoga help increase balance and flexibility and strength, it also helps keep you having nice posture throughout the day. The benefits transition on and off of your mat. Yoga is a really good detox. It helps flush your system because you're sweating out a lot of the toxins that your body has built up throughout the day between the products that you use and your environment. And it's a good way, whether you do yoga or any other form of exercise, to sweat and help release some toxins. Yoga is really good at boosting your immune system. It also aids in digestion, especially if you're doing twisting postures. It helps your blood circulate. It helps increase your endurance and also helps your oxygen intake. So as you breathe in a yoga class, you learn to breathe deeper into your lungs, which helps you take in more air. The last couple benefits of practice, and there's many, many more. I'll actually link to an article that I found that is really good at explaining multiple different benefits of yoga. If you practice late at night or later in the night, it's a good transition to wind you down from your day. It actually helps you relax and it helps you sleep better. And then finally, yoga is really good for overall self-care. The more in tune you are with your body and your breath, the more you're able to recognize when you're starting to get worn down or sick or have any sort of fatigue. So do take care of yourself, listen to your body. I hope this is helpful if you're thinking of taking your first yoga class or if you're well into your practice. I'd love to hear how yoga found you and what are your favorite postures. See you next time.